At the centre of any burn supper is the bard's poetry and song. Works including the Selkirk Grace, Scotch Drink to a Haggis and Auld Lang Syne have historically formed an important part of the running order. There is another work, of course, that features widely in Burns Night celebrations, and that is Burns' iconic narrative poem, Tam o' Shanter, a poem that captures the sociability and conviviality Burns was so fond of in the opening lines, which see Tam boozing at the nappy with his ancient, trusty, druthy crony, Suitor Johnny. The poem is fast, furious, and funny and profound in equal measure, and has long inspired performers, creatives, and manufacturers so that it's permeated Scottish culture on a number of levels. Take this 19th century Mauchlinware pincushion, for example, and of course we're in a VR gallery, so I can lift this out of its case and bring it closer for you to see, make it a little bit larger perhaps. And this is a souvenir of Alloway Kirk, the scene for the famous witch's dance in Burns' poem. If I rotate it, you'll see that it's made of wood grown in the banks of the Doon. It was very common in the years following Burns' death and throughout the 19th century for people to collect wood or stones from places associated with Burns and his works. In the 21st century, we can actually use virtual reality to teleport to the exact spot represented on this object. And so, with a click of my controller, let's travel back in time. Here we are in Alloway Kirkyard as it would have appeared in the 18th century. It's been created with close reference to Francis Gross's 1791 Antiquities of Scotland, here provided by the University of Glasgow's Special Collections. Let's take a look. It was the prospect of the Kirk's inclusion in this book that prompted Burns to write Tam o' Shanter, and I'll just show you. Here it appears, next to Gross's sketch of the Kirk, as perhaps the longest and most famous footnote of all time. And if I spin that around, you'll see just how faithfully the Kirk has been represented in the VR environment. Ultimately, what CRBS have created with Edify is an environment where people can experience the magic that happens when text, location and objects collide in the creation of an iconic cultural memory, in this case Burns's. But central to his cultural memory, to his legacy, are of course his poems and songs. And bearing that in mind, it's time for us to immerse ourselves in Alloway Kirk as Burns describes it in his poem. Let's go. This supernatural environment is resplendent in the imagery of Burns's poem. The lightnings flash from pole to pole, near and more near the thunders roll, when glimmering through the groaning trees, Kirk Alloway seemed in a blaze. Through ilka bore the beams were glancing, and loud resounded mirth and dancing. Now join me as I take a walk or a teleport into this haunted building. Across the kirkyard, past the grave of William Burness, Burns's father, and finally, into the kirk, where once again Burns's imagery has been faithfully represented. Open coffins, swords and axes, the blades that we read about in the poem. And if we glance up the way, those ominous looking rafters from which so many relics and souvenirs would be crafted in the years following the composition of Burns's poem.